So as a fire prevention specialist, my main job and focus is to do the annual fire inspections, and we focus on the state mandated inspections, such as the multifamily residences, schools, hotels, and those all have to be inspected every year. When we're doing an inspection, specifically an annual fire inspection, the first thing we're gonna do is our inspection starts when we're pulling up on scene. So we're gonna look at, number one, the addressing of the property and make sure that it is visible from the street. So when in an emergency, responding units can see the addressing and it doesn't delay their response. I'm gonna first look at access inside the building in an emergency. So if this is locked, commercial buildings should all have what is called a Knox box installed. And that is a key locked box that in an emergency situation that the firefighters or paramedics, depending on the situation, have access to the building. And then once I enter the building, I'm starting to do my internal inspection. One of the things I might first look for is if I look up and I see fire sprinklers in the ceiling, I know the building is sprinklered. So I know I'm gonna have to check a fire sprinkler riser. It's gonna have an alarm system. So I'm also gonna make sure that the alarm panel is clear and then also that the annual maintenance has maintained. So as we're doing our inspections, we're gonna go in pretty much every door that we see, and we're gonna look in any offices or storage rooms or anything like that. So one of our main jobs when we do fire inspection is to look at the fire extinguishers and make sure that they have been tested by a certified company. So we wanna make sure that their tag has the registered fire marshal seal on it and that it has a date punched in on when that fire extinguisher was inspected and tested. And if it's within a year, then that fire extinguisher is good. So we will go through and check these fire doors to make sure that they function properly, that they self-close at a reasonable rate, and that they do self-latch. One of the other things that we will do is we will test exit lighting and emergency lighting. A lot of times those exit signs are removed or damaged, so we will have to make sure, of course, number one, they're present, number two, that they function correctly. So again, I'm checking any exit doors that I come across to make sure that they function and they open, they're not locked from the inside so that people in an emergency could get out and that they're not blocked. So the first thing we're gonna look for in this case is that the riser room is marked appropriately. And then we're gonna look in here, and this is a fire riser for this building. And basically we're just looking for a couple things in here. Number one, we're looking at the integrity of the riser. We're making sure that there's water in the gauge. So that tells us the pressure at which the water is in the system. These boxes we're also gonna look into, and we wanna make sure that there are spare heads for that specific sprinkler system. We wanna make sure that they're set up with the correct occupancy. So we're gonna look for signs like this that tell us how many people are allowed in there. One of the first things that fire crews will do in a fire is shut down the utilities. When we're in the electrical room, we wanna look at the breaker boxes to test the integrity of the box, make sure the doors close. So having access to the electrical panels and the breakers is very important for them to be able to shut down. Another thing that we will look at is that they have an appropriate evacuation plan, and one that is hung in a conspicuous location and kind of tells people and directs people in an emergency which way to go. So we want to make sure both safety for occupants and, like I said before, firefighters or paramedics in the case of an emergency have access to the building, that fire protection systems are still in service and tested to assure that they can protect the residents or occupants of a building, and basically just make sure that that building is safe throughout its entire life.